In this video, I am going to explain about IEEE 802 standard. First, I'll explain what is IEEE. IEEE stands for Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers. It is a non-profit organization. Now, I'll explain what is IEEE with the help of an example. We know that ISI marked products are valid products and quality checked products. So, we can trust and use those products. In the similar way, IEEE sets standards for electrical and electronic equipments. Now, let us see what is standard. While talking about products, sometimes we say, this product is a standard product. That is, its quality is good and it may work for longer time. If we say, this product is not a standard product, means its quality is not good and it may not work for longer time. That is, standard is somewhat related to quality, right? IEEE sets standards to electrical and electronic equipments. Now, let us see what is IEEE 802 standard. So, we will see IEEE 802 standard. I'll explain IEEE 802 standard with the help of an example. Here is a laptop and a PC. Let us assume that these two devices are different in their architecture. In order to connect these two systems, which are entirely different in their architecture, in the year 1985, the Computer Society of IEEE started a project called Project 802 to set standards and protocols to make the intercommunication possible between the systems which are different in their architecture. We know that OSI model is a 7-layer model and it is used to connect two systems which are entirely different in their architecture, but it's a theoretical model. But Project 802 does not want to replace any part of the OSI model. Instead, it specifies the functions for the physical layer, data link layer, to allow intercommunication, that is, communication between the systems. The relationship of IEEE 802 project to the OSI model is shown in this figure. The IEEE has subdivided the data link layer into two sublayers, logical link control layer and medium access control layer. The logical link control layer is non-architecture specific. That is, LANs can be Ethernet LANs or token bus, token ring LANs. So, the logical link control layer is non-architecture specific. So, it is same for all the LANs. But the medium access control sublayer, on the other hand, is specific to the LAN. Is specific to the LAN type being used. That is, medium access control is different for each LAN type. Now we will see some points about logical link control layer and medium access control layer. The logical link control sublayer deals with the flow control and error control. And the data unit in the logical link control layer protocol, logical link control layer is called protocol data unit PDU. The PDU contains four fields as shown in the figure. Those are destination service access point, source service access point, control field, and information field. The destination service access point address field has 8 bits, of which 1 bit stores the address type of the destination and the remaining 7 bits stores the actual address. If the address type bit is set to 0, then the actual address would be individual address. If it is set to 1, then the actual address is a group address. And the next one is source service access point. The source service access point address field also has 8 bits, of which 1 bit stores the command or response identifier, and the remaining 7 bits stores the actual address. The actual address is always an individual address. If the command or response identifier bit is set to 0, then it's a command. If it is set to 1, then it is a response. The control field may be 7 or 16 bits long. It contains the information about total number of frames sent and received. It is used for data, error recovery, flow control. And the last one is information field. The information field is of variable length. In Ethernet, this field has up to 1500 bytes of data. And the next one is medium access control layer. The responsibility of medium access control sublayer is to allocate channels to host for data transmission, and it takes the channels back when the transmission is complete. There are several strategies for allocation and deallocation of channel. For example, Ethernet uses the CSMA by CD, and token passing method is used for token ring and token bus LANs. From this we can say that accessing the medium is different in different LANs. So medium access control layer is different for each LAN, whereas logical link control layer is the same for all the LANs. These points are shown in this figure. Here, the logical link control layer is same for all the LANs, but medium access control layer is different for different LANs because different LANs use different medium accessing methods. In addition to two sublayers, Project 802 contains a section called internetworking to solve the internetworking issues. This section assures the compatibilities of the different LANs. Finally, the strength of the Project 802 is modularity. That is, it subdivides the functions necessary for LAN management. Each subdivision is identified by a number. For example, 802.1 is for internet working, IEEE 802.2 is for logical link control, IEEE 802.3 is for CSMA by CD, that is Ethernet. IEEE 802.4 is for token bus. IEEE 802.5 is for token ring. So this is about IEEE 802 standard.